So let's look at this classical definition of probability. Now this is where all the chapter will start. So the thing with this chapter is it doesn't have a lot of formulas, a few very, very basic formulas, but the only difficulty comes in you know, applying this formula, in deducing the case to something numerical and then applying the formula rightly. So basically you have S as your sample space, right? So this is your sample space. Then the probability of occurrence of an event E, so you might have an event E in this sample space, which might be this big, right? So it might have these many elements in E, and so these many in total. So probability of E, which is P of E, is denoted by this very, very simple formula, that is N of E by N of S, or the number of elements in E divided by the number of elements in S, or cases favorable to E by total number of cases. So what you simply do is you basically carry out an experiment, check how many of those outcomes, check the total number of outcomes, right? The total number of outcomes will make your sample space. From that, you need to choose the number of outcomes which are basically lying in your event E. So first you need to define what your event is. Then in that event, you need to see how many cases come. 1, 2, 3, how many such cases come? So you need to put that number here, and then you need to divide that by the total number of cases. In fact, this formula is all of the chapter, but the only difficulty comes in its execution. So let's take a very, very basic example. So something like a dice is rolled, the sample space will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if I tell you that your event E is number of odd numbers, event E is getting an odd number, So your sample space has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 elements. In that, your favorable cases are basically 1, 3, and 5. These are your 3 odd numbers, right? So basically, an odd number, the probability is number of elements in E, that is 3, right? 3 elements divided by total number of elements, that's 6. So 3 by 6 is 1 by 2. This is the probability of getting an odd number, right? So this is how simple it is. This was just a very, very basic example to understand how to apply this definition. You must have already seen this in your 10th also, but I just wanted to repeat it. So with this done, let's move on to the next subtopic. This module is just to prove that identity, that probability of any event lies between 0 and 1. So let's see. So the value of probability of occurrence of an event, why does it lie between 0 and 1? So let S be your sample space and E be your event, right? Now, so E is a subset of S, and pi is a subset of E. Basically, pi is a subset of everything. Pi means there is no element in the set, right? That is a subset of everything. So basically, N of pi is less than or equal to N of E, is less than or equal to N of S. So basically, sample space S. This might have a lot of elements, right? Lot of elements, lot of points, lot of outcomes. From this might be your E. So the elements in E, these three pink dots, the elements in E are obviously less than elements in S in total, right? And obviously, this has to be greater than or equal to 0. 0 is greater than or less than or equal to N of E, less than or equal to N of S, and if you divide N of S on all sides, you get 0 less than or equal to N of E by N of S is P of S, and N of S by N of S is 1. So that's why the probability of any event lies between 0 and 1. It will be 0, the probability will be 0 when what you want does not lie in the sample space at all, right? So if you want something, so these are your outcomes. If you take an event E, which is none of these outcomes, and your sample space is S, then the probability will be 0, right? And it will be 1 when your event E is basically the sample space itself. You're taking all the cases, then your probability will be 1. And if you take anything other than these two cases, then the probability will lie between 0 and 1. That is the reason why the probability of any event is either equal to 0 or greater than it, and is either equal to 1 or less than it. Let's prove this very simple identity. If E be any event and E dash be the complement of the event E, then P of E plus P of E dash equal to 1. That means you take any event A, take its probability, and you take the probability of its complement, this should add up to 1. Why is that? So let this be your sample space S. So your event E, right, if you take the event E, N of E actually means all these cases which lie inside this. And N of E dash, if you add N of E dash to this, then you're talking about the cases which are in the sample space but outside this blue box, outside this blue oval. That is basically these cases which are outside the blue oval but still in the sample space. So as you can see, when you add these two elements, the number of elements, you get the total number of elements in the subset. So you get a total number of elements in the subset. Now if you divide with N of S on all sides, if you divide with N of S on all sides, this P of E, this N of E by N of S is probability of E plus N of E dash by N of S is probability of E dash, right? Probability of E not happening. This is probability of E happening plus probability of E not happening is equals to 1, right? So this was the identity that we needed to prove, that probability of an element, probability of an event and probability of its complement. If you sum them up, you should get 1 as your result.